This is Jason Gentile of Apella Capital. Welcome to our third quarter 2017 portfolio review. Today, we'll be discussing current events, performance by asset class, broad market classes, and factor exposure over time. This quarter, Fed Chairwoman Janet Yellen addressed the lasting effects of the recent natural disasters and acknowledged that these events have devastated many communities and may impact economic activity in the near future. However, as history has shown us, these events are unlikely to impact the national economy in the long run. Inflation is expected to be impacted. However, it remains below 2%. If there were a thermometer tracking the temperature of the political friction with North Korea, it's certainly trending on the hotter side and continuing to heat up. President Trump signed an executive order which will enable the U.S. to sanction individual companies and institutions that trade with North Korea in an attempt to isolate Pyongyang, further constricting North Korea's economy. The hope here is that isolating Pyongyang will put a chokehold on North Korea's nuclear weapons program, which, as President Trump stated in the UN September meeting, poses a threat to the entire world with an unthinkable loss of human life. Although some say it's more smoke and less fire right now, the blueprint for tax reform and formal plans are expected to be released in the coming weeks and months. The plan agreed upon right now includes adding to the federal deficit in order to set the path for a $1.5 trillion tax cut over the next 10 years. Similar to the Fed's quantitative easing, this tax cut is being put in motion with the hopes of stimulating economic growth. Global equity markets continued their positive trajectory from the first and second quarters of 2017, gaining 5.32% in the third. Global markets have gained over 17% so far this year to date and are up over 18% over the last year. Emerging markets were atop the performance list again, making it three straight quarters being the top performer. Emerging markets returned 8.04% in the third quarter and are up 28.14% year to date. International developed markets sustained a strong performance in the second quarter and returned 5.69% in the third. Expanding this timeframe only adds to international developed market performance, which boasts gains over 19% this year to date and over the last year. U.S. markets pulled their performance up from previous quarters and brought in gains of  4.53% in quarter three. U.S. market performance also holds up across all timeframes, with the year-to-date one, three, and five-year timeframes returning 13.97%, 18.67%, 10.78%, and 14.26%, respectively. It's not a matter of if, but when the interest rate increase will occur. Despite the impending increases, U.S. fixed income markets ended up the third quarter 0.85% and are up over 3% this year to date. In addition, U.S. TIPS went from losses in the second quarter to gains of 0.86% in the third. Municipal bonds had a nice third quarter, turning in gains of just over 1%. Muni bonds have seen gains of 4.66% this year to date and have seen gains of over 3.19%, 3.01%, and 4.52% over the last three, five, and 10-year timeframes. Global factor performance continued its strong trend in 2017, with positive performance across the board in the third quarter. Growth stocks outperformed value stocks again this quarter in the U.S. and emerging markets. However, this trend did not hold up for another quarter in international developed markets, where international developed market value stocks outperformed growth stocks by 1.08%. U.S. REITs took a slight dip from its 1.64% return in the second quarter to a relatively flat 0.38% return in the third quarter of 2017. Although U.S. REITs have losses of nearly 1% over the last year, they have returns of over 9% across both the three and five-year timeframes. Small cap stocks put together back-to-back positive quarters in the U.S., emerging, and international developed markets with the returns of 5.54%, 5.78%, and 7.33%, respectively. Year to date, both emerging and international developed market small cap stocks have returns of over 22%. Over the last five-year window, small cap continues to hold up well with gains of over 14% in the U.S., 4.9% in emerging markets, and 11% international developed markets. Momentum continues to produce in the third quarter of 2017, up 7.97% in the U.S., 11.17% in emerging markets, and 7.62% in international developed markets. Year-to-date, momentum is up 27.55%. Over the last year, U.S. momentum is up 25.67%. Over the last 3 years, U.S. momentum is up 15.49%. And over the last 5 years, U.S. momentum is up 17.39%. As previously said, momentum is consistently producing. As this trend holds true across emerging and international developed markets as well, with momentum up 28.83% and 17.72% respectively over the last year. This trend holds true across emerging and international developed markets as well, with momentum up 28.83% and 17.72% respectively over the last year. Although it was slightly less than value, small cap, and momentum, the quality factor added gains across the U.S., emerging, and international developed markets for the second straight quarter, most notably in the U.S. with a 4.74% third quarter return. In the U.S., momentum, small, and quality all outperformed the market. In international developed markets, value, momentum, and small cap outperformed the market. Similar to last quarter, minimum volatility took the caboose for the factors, turning in a 3.41% third quarter return. Although minimum volatility has lagged as far as exposures go over the past few quarters, the minimum volatility factor is outperforming global markets over the last 3, 5, and 10-year timeframes. This is Jason Gentile with Apella Capital. Thank you for taking the time to listen to this update for the third quarter of 2017.